Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy. In this tutorial video, we are going to learn the foundation of polygon modeling. We will start by discussing the difference between primitive and editable objects. Then, we will discuss the subobject modes available inside editable poly. And finally, we will model a simple character head from a teapot object. When you first create an object in 3ds Max, you actually create a primitive type object. The term primitives in 3ds Max are objects that still hold the original parameters. For example, if we create a teapot, like so, while the teapot object is selected in the modify panel, you can still see its original parameters. We can change the radius, the segments, the smoothing mode, and the other stuff down here that relate to the teapot body part's visibility. Again, this is an example of a primitive object. While you can do a lot with primitive objects, there is a limit to what you can do. For example, what if we want to add a mouth here, and add two eye sockets here, and we want to turn the spout downward so it looks like an elephant trunk? You cannot do that if the object is still in a primitive state. Essentially, if you want to do more with 3D objects, then you need to convert them into editable objects. So what is an editable object then? Editable objects are objects that already lost their basic parameters, but in return, you can access their sub-objects and use many different modeling features that are not available before in a primitive mode. You need to be aware though, once it is an editable object, it will always be an editable object. Unless you still have some undo level left, you cannot convert an editable object back to a primitive object. So how can we convert a primitive object to an editable object then? Well, it is very easy. Simply right-click, and in the quad menu, you will find this convert to options. We can choose between these editable object types, mesh, poly, patch, and nurbs. I won't be discussing in detail each of these editable object types in this video. For short, if you are working with 3ds Max, 99% you always want to use the editable poly object type. So, we will be focusing on this type only from now on. After converting a teapot object into an editable poly object, in the modify panel, you will not find the previous teapot parameters anymore. But you can access the sub-objects which are the vertices, edges, borders, polygons, and elements. And we also have all of these tools that we can use for 3D modeling, not to mention the additional tools in ribbon interface up here. Let's focus on the sub-object modes. To see the sub-object better, we can display the edges in the viewport by pressing F4 on the keyboard. Or, if you ever forget the shortcut, you can click on the rightmost viewport menu here, and then make sure that this option, Edge Faces, is turned on. Alright, the first sub-object mode is the vertex mode. You can access it by clicking on this icon here. Vertex is basically a point in 3D space. The plural form of vertex is vertices. In this mode, we can select the points that make up the geometry. We can use any of the selection techniques that we've learned before to select the vertices. For example, we can use the lasso region selection mode. We can add more selection by holding Ctrl and subtract the selection by holding Alt. You can try an experiment with the other selection mode. In this mode also, you can transform selected vertices using all the techniques we've discussed before. For example, if you activate the move mode, you can move these vertices to any location you like. If you activate the rotate mode, you can rotate them. And if you are in a scale mode, you can scale them. So from this simple example, you understand that you can basically reshape editable objects to anything that you want. Before we discuss the next sub-object mode, if you go to the Create panel and create another teapot and convert this teapot also into an editable poly object, if you go to the Modify panel while this new teapot is selected and then activate the vertex mode, you can select the vertices of this object. But now, you cannot select the ones that belong to the first teapot. Why is that? Well, this is the behavior of the subobject editing that I want to discuss. If you are in a subobject mode, you are constrained to edit only the object that you have selected. If you want to edit this object again, first, you need to go back to the top level mode or the object mode. To do that, you can simply click the vertex icon again until it is off. Now you can freely select any object in the scene. To edit the vertices of this object, make sure the object is selected and then click on the vertex icon again. You can now select or transform the vertices of this object, but you won't be able to do this on the vertices belonging to the other object. I'm sure you get the idea here. Now let's discuss the other subobject modes. The second subobject mode is the edge mode. Edges are basically straight lines that connect the vertices. In this mode, you can edit the edges. Now, when I said edit, it essentially means three things. First, you can select edges using various selection methods as we discussed earlier. Second, you can also transform them using various transformation methods including movement, rotation, and scale. And third, you can access a variety of modeling features specific to edges. Notice that what you see down here in the edge mode is different from what you see in the vertex mode. Basically, each of the subobject modes offers a different set of modeling features. The next subobject mode is the border mode. A border is basically a group of connected edges that exist around holes or the boundary. So in this mode, if you click on one of the edges on a boundary of the lead part, the whole edges around that part will get selected. We can move this up to see what we have selected. Now, you can click drag like this on the tip of the spout. You can see that only the boundary edges get selected. Other edges will not be affected. The next subobject mode is the polygon mode. A polygon is basically a plane formed by three or more edges. In this mode, you can edit the polygons such as selecting polygons, do transformation on them, and access the modeling features related to polygons. The last subobject mode is the element mode. An element is basically a group of polygons that are connected and form an independent structure inside a single object. So, for this teapot object example, we actually have four elements: the lead part, the body part, the handle, and the spout. You can select and edit each of these parts easily if you are in the element mode. Now, besides using these icons here, there are three other methods that you can use to access subobject modes. First, if you click on this caret button to expand it, you will see a list of the subobject names. With this, you can go to the vertex mode, edge mode, border mode, polygon mode, and element mode. To go back to the top level mode, you can click on the editable poly name here. The next method is by using the quad menu. To do this, just do a right click on the viewport. Remember, in order for this to work, you need to have an editable poly object selected. Notice at the top left menu, you can see the subobject names and also the top level option. If you click on vertex, for example, you are now in a vertex subobject mode. This is the edge mode, the border mode, the polygon mode, and the element mode. To go back to the top level mode, as you may already guess it, you can click on this option here. The last method is by using keyboard shortcuts. For this, you need to access the number keys on a keyboard. Not the ones on the numpad, but the ones on the left side, on the top of the Q, W, E, and R letter keys. Number 1 is for the vertex subobject mode. Number 2 is for the edge mode. Number 3 is for the border mode. 4 is for the polygon mode. And 5 is for the element mode. To go back to the top level mode, you need to press the same number as the current active subobject mode. So, if you are in the element mode, pressing 5 again will take you back to the top level mode. To finish up this tutorial video, let's model a simple character head from a teapot object. This is so we have something to practice what we've learned so far. we are also going to cover several new things along the way. First, of course, we will need a teapot object. To center the teapot, go to the move mode and zero out all of the X, Y, and Z coordinate values. We can do this by right-clicking on the spinners. If you go to the modify panel, make sure you have the default settings, especially for the segment's value, which is now set to 8. Next, convert the teapot into an editable poly so we can access its subobjects. And to see the edges, you can press F4 on the keyboard. Next, to add a mouth, we can go to the edge mode. Then, to select the edges on the mouth area, you can do this manually by selecting one edge, then hold Ctrl and keep clicking more edges like this. But there is a faster method. For this, you need to hold Shift first, then click here, then here, then here, then finally here. Now, if you are using 3ds Max 2021.2 or above, there is even a better workflow for selecting connected edges like this. If you are still using an older version of 3ds Max, then you just have to stick with the manual method. Next, we can move this back a bit. And also up. So we have something like this. Next, we want to transform the spout into a nose. First, go to the element mode. Select the spout element. To rotate this exactly 180 degrees, you need to be in the rotate mode. And also activate the angle snap mode. With the angle snap turned on, the rotation will snap per 5 degrees increment. Just watch the value down here as you rotate the object. Make sure you stop when you reach exactly 180 degrees. Okay, back to the move mode. And move this down a bit. I think this is too low. Next, for the eye sockets, go to the polygon mode. And then select these 3 polygons here. And 3 polygons here. Then move them back a little. And move them down as well. Select this polygon, hold Ctrl, and this one also. Move them up like so. Then, we want to select these polygons on the forehead line. We can do this using the Shift method. So, hold Shift, and then click here. Then click here. Then, we can move these polygons forward. And the face is basically done. We can go back to the top level mode and hide the edges by pressing F4. This is what we have so far. I know this is very simple, but at least from this example, you understand how subobjects and 3D modeling work in general. If you want to add eyeballs, it will be easier just to create separate sphere objects. Now, for our case, we can use the auto grid feature. With this feature, we can snap to any surface where the mouse cursor is located. We haven't discussed creating symmetrical objects yet, so for now, it is okay if the eyes are not perfectly symmetrical. But at least we can make the color uniform. Make sure both of them are selected. Go to the Modify panel, and click here to pick a new object color. Let's just pick white for now. And this is the final result of our exercise. If you are new to 3ds Max, or even never used 3D software before, and you want to start learning and mastering 3D modeling using 3ds Max in the quickest way possible, you definitely need to take this course. You will be guided to model all these 3D objects from start to finish, while at the same time learn important concepts in 3D graphics step by step along the way. There are more than 9 hours of quality educational content in this course. So join the course now through the link I provided below. As always, subscribe to my channel, share the video, give a thumbs up if you like the video, and give a thumbs down if you hate the video. Please check out other tutorials on my channel. Wassalamualaikum.